A new study by the Secret Service has determined that school shootings are preventable, and the attackers show similar warning signs.
In tonight's Education Matters, Juanita Stevenson joins us with how the Office of the Fresno County Superintendent of Schools is already working on a prevention plan.
Well, authorities say the key to preventing school violence is to not only know the early warning signs, but reacting to them. Valley school districts are now getting the training they need to identify students who may be in crisis and then to take action.
Snapshots from the latest school shooting. This one at Saugus High School in Santa Clarita, California. The gunman was a 16-year-old fellow student. Weeks after the shooting, authorities still don't have a clear reason why.
We did not find any manifesto, any diary that spelled it out, any suicide note or any writings which will clearly identify his motive.
Friends who knew the shooter were stunned, calling the teenager a smart kid who showed no signs of aggressive behavior. Digging deeper, authorities say he had a troubled home life and was having relationship problems. School psychologist John Van Driel says these may have been warning signs, and his job is to get people to recognize them.
The importance of understanding the risk factors that might be indicating that a student is thinking of hurting themselves or hurting others or both, or is going to drop out, or drugs and alcohol. Those risk factors are out there. They're not always loud, but they're noticeable if you know what to look for.
Van Driel is an expert in threat assessment management. He was in Fresno to help train school officials to become better at assessing and mitigating behavioral threats on campus.
I guess the bumper sticker is, we can't predict these kinds of things, but we can prevent them if we know what to look for.
The Office of the Fresno County Superintendent of Schools put on this three-day workshop. 22 of the county's school districts sent representatives to participate in the training.
This training definitely entails a proactive approach. We're trying to head off a threat before it becomes actual school violence.
The school staff sitting around these tables will make up each district's behavioral threat assessment team. They are superintendents, school psychologists, resource officers, teachers, bus drivers, people who interact with students on a daily basis.
That's the beauty of making up that multidisciplinary team, where we can all take a different lens at that threat, and we can treat that student equitably, and we can treat that student so that there is no harm to the school, but yet we're making relationships, and we're making sure that student understands that the school and the school staff are supportive.
Officials say not all school threats are the same, and the goal is to help staff be able to identify the seriousness of the threats and get to students before there is a crisis.
And there are many instances where people did that and they did prevent an event or at least stop somebody from going down that road to think about it. But there are a number of events that have been prevented that are documented.
Now, the school officials who have participated in that workshop will now go back to their own homeschool districts and train staff who will make up their individual behavioral threat assessment team. So the goal is for every district to have one, every school campus to have one.
You know, it's so sad that we have to, that this has to be done, but it's obviously so important that they're doing it.
Yeah. And now they have really good information to work with.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, that's good. We got to prevent these school shootings.
Yeah.
All right. Juanita, thank you.